Purjewala right there going and responding. But first up, we're getting some breaking news coming in. We'll have to go straight across to it. News just coming in. Gehlot camp claiming more MLAs have deserted pilot. That's the latest that is coming in right there. What you heard right now was Randeep Singh Surjewala also hitting out at Sachin Pilot, saying go ahead and vacate that hotel where your loyalist MLAs and you are occupying, and that would prove that you are not joining the BJP. Because remember, Sachin Pilot has made the claim that he's not going to be joining the BJP. But Randeep Singh Surjewala has hit back, and now Gehlot camp is claiming that more MLAs have deserted Pilot as well. So the game on, Rajasthan, still a lot of political drama transpiring right there. If the Gehlot camp says and claims that more MLAs have deserted Pilot, the numbers are something that we do not know at the moment, because these are claims coming in from Gehlot camp and claims coming in from Pilot camp. Pilot camp claiming certain amount of MLAs with them, but Gehlot saying that more MLAs have gone ahead and deserted Sachin Pilot. Devankur Vadhavan is joining us in just about a bit for the very latest. But latest coming in right there, let's encapsulate what all has transpired. Sachin Pilot, remember, was sacked. Gehlot camps is now claiming that more MLAs have deserted Pilot. Randeep Singh Surjewala hitting out at Sachin Pilot. Randeep Singh Surjewala going on to say, if you're not joining the BJP, leave the Gurugram Hotel right now. Ashutosh is now joining us for the very latest on this. Ashutosh, how true are these claims made by Ashok Gehlot that more MLAs have deserted Sachin Pilot? At the moment, from your sources, what are the figures really looking like on both the factions? Of course, not to forget, Surjewala has made a strong claim, attacked Sachin Pilot, saying, if you're not joining the BJP, then go ahead and vacate that hotel where you're staying in Manesar.
So that what it seems that even Ashutosh, after, you know, going harsh against Sachin Pilot, Congress has come back and offering olive branch back to Sachin Pilot, that come back to the party. It is not too late. Clearly, the claims that were first being made from Sachin Pilot camp and then Ashok Gehlot camp, what Surjewala has said, that clearly seems to be that the central leadership of the Congress party, what it has decided, that they are still open and keeping the window open for Sachin Pilot's return. However, as far as Sachin Pilot is concerned, he is meeting his loyal MLAs at ITC Grand Hotel. But now the clear invitation to Sachin Pilot, it is not too late. And if you still believe in Congress leadership, in that ideology, come back. Here all the media, since Congress very much know that all the media cameras are right outside the, you know, deployed here at the hotel. He should come out and speak what the Congress has offered, whether he agree to those points or not.
Absolutely. So that's the big story that we are tracking at the moment. I believe we have one more reporter with us joining us on this story. But Ashutosh, in the meanwhile, Randeep Surjewala also made a very strong point right there. Two things that he said on Sachin Pilot, rejecting the claim that he's joining the BJP. He has gone ahead and said that if you are really not joining the BJP, then leave the Gurugram Hotel. The other claim that he has made is that you are more than welcome to come back home. The doors are still open. So this entire scenario, really, Ashutosh, at the moment can go either way. All the three options that we've been discussing since the morning of him returning back to the Congress party or starting his own political party or going to the BJP, all three options are in front of him at the moment.
So, well, don't forget, even the Congress leadership, be it the center or in Rajasthan, have been saying that there are 3 to 4 MLAs who were Sachin Pilot loyalists, were staying in this hotel in Haryana and left back to Jaipur. But they did not appear on the camera at the moment, what we know. In the press conference, yes, that is very significant and most important, that how Congress party once again offering a olive branch to Sachin Pilot, that it is not too late. Whatever the differences were between Ashok Gehlot and Sachin Pilot can be sorted out. And it seems that central leadership of the Congress party has again intervened, and perhaps they pretty much value the importance and significance of Sachin Pilot in that state. And clearly, after what has happened in Madhya Pradesh, clearly the Congress does not want to get it repeated in the state of Rajasthan, as such, as large as state Rajasthan. So clearly this is once again, you know, an effort being to patch up and bring back Sachin Pilot home. But we'll have to see the harsh words used by Ashok Gehlot against Sachin Pilot, and whatever has happened, the incident that have unfolded from last evening till this afternoon, whether Sachin Pilot is going to agree on those terms and what are going to be those further terms. In fact, one of the reporter in the press conference also asked the question that you, since you are appealing all these MLAs to come back, including Sachin Pilot, will they be given the same position before they were suspended from the party, before they were removed from their portfolio? So those questions Congress has not responded yet. We'll have to see the further development. But yes, we all are right here at ITC Hotel waiting for Sachin Pilot to come, and we'll have to see whether he's going to speak or not. Remember, since last evening, it was anticipated that Sachin Pilot will break
right, hold on right there, Ashutosh. I'm coming back to you, but Moushami is also joining us. Moushami, as far as the Congress High Command is concerned, and you track the Congress Party so closely, as far as the High Command is concerned, what kind of an intervention are we seeing in this particular matter? Because when the intervention was needed, the Congress High Command did not intervene, and now efforts are being made back. Now with Ranjit Surjewala also going on and saying that our doors are open, you're welcome to come back home as well. Looks like there's an olive branch that is being extended right there to Sachin Pilot as well. In terms of where the High Command stands at the moment, what are your sources telling you?
Chaiti, see, it's not completely, we cannot completely say that there was no intervention. Sachin Pilot was given 4 days to respond. He was given a lot of time to come back to the Congress fold, and this entire situation, there was attempt by several leaders, including P. Chidambaram. Ahmed Patel made 12 phone calls to him. We are told Priyanka Gandhi called him 4-5 times. Even Rahul Gandhi called him once. So, pardon me. So there were several attempts by Congress leadership to, in fact, ensure that Sachin would be taken care of. The commitment that Rahul Gandhi had given that he would be made the chief minister at one point or the other in the fag end of the entire Congress government in Rajasthan still holds on. But despite that, things had come to a knot, and the Congress leadership is also not too happy about the direct attack that Ashok Gehlot has in fact made on Sachin Pilot, whether it's sending a notice or the verbal duel. They want to de-escalate the situation because somewhere they feel that the final damage is of the Congress party. But despite that, they're not willing to drag it any longer because it's also embarrassing for the party. We will have to wait and see how Sachin Pilot in fact responds to the entire olive branch that has been offered by Randeep Surjewala, even as it is conditional. It is also attacking in some nature because he says that you are using the facilities of the BJP. That's in a way discrediting what Sachin Pilot said.
Congress party leaders who are not happy with Gehlot's comments on Sachin Pilot. That's the news that is just trickling in. I'm being told at the moment, sources indicating the party high command not too happy with Ashok Gehlot making direct attack at Sachin. We had reported earlier that Gehlot had been pulled up by the party leadership for notice being sent to Sachin as well. So this is a big development that is coming in, that the high command not happy with Ashok Gehlot making direct attack at Sachin Pilot. Moushami still continues to be with us. Moushami, on one hand, you have the High Command not very happy that Ashok Gehlot is making direct attack at Sachin, which somewhere means that the High Command is still hoping for a comeback of Sachin Pilot as well. But what fails everybody at the moment is that while Priyanka Gandhi Vadra must have tried to reach out to Sachin Pilot, Ahmed Patel must have reached out, Rahul Gandhi made that one phone call. Why is it the Congress President Sonia Gandhi not even making one phone call?
See, clearly, you know, one senior Congress leader said that Sachin has a very good equation with the family. It's not only him. His father had a very different equation with the Gandhi family. And many, you know, scornfully also say that he is the boy with the golden spoon. In fact, there is a sense of entitlement in a certain breed of Congress leaders, and Sachin was one of them. So they are also talking about the privileges that Sachin had, and that privilege, they say, was also seen in the way they gave him a lot of leeway in saying and doing whatever he did, and making these repeated offers. If you can very well understand that even today, after he has been removed from the post of PCC President and Deputy CM. Yet again, Randeep Surjewala reaching out to Sachin Pilot is a climb down in the Congress position. If it would have been, I'm not very sure, if it would have been an Ashok Tavar or an Ajoy Kumar, Congress party would have been so graceful or perhaps so compromising. So importantly, you know, there is a point in the entire drama that is unfolding that this is Sachin Pilot. There is a big section of the Congress that feels that if this can happen to a firebrand leader like Sachin Pilot, who has a good amount of following in the younger lot, then what will be our future? So that
done right there, Maushami. Dev Ankur is also joining us. Dev, I'm going to come back to this point again. The Congress high command seems at the moment, and this is what it seemingly looks like, that they're sitting on some sort of a high horse where Sonia Gandhi does not pick up the phone on Sachin Pilot. You've got emissaries that are being sent from by the Congress party to go and have a word with him. Ahmed Patel tries to reach him out. Rahul Gandhi tries to reach out to him as well. But nobody is really calling him to sit across the table, discuss the modalities of what his new role with the Congress party is going to be like in case he comes back. And here he's unhappy, clearly being the deputy chief minister as well. He wants to go for that top job of being the chief minister. How is this even going to pan out?
Well, clearly, you know, Sonia Gandhi seems to have put her hand up in the sense that she wants the party to make an effort once again to ensure that Sachin Pilot returns to the mainstream fold. This is the area outside the Fairmont Hotel. Chaiti, behind me is this luxurious property in Jaipur where all these MLAs have been put up. And what happened about 1.5 hours ago was Ashok Gehlot walked out, came out in his vehicle, and he was leaving towards his residence. But he stopped, he spoke with the media persons, and hardly half a kilometer away from there, he got a call on his phone. The visuals were there. He was speaking with someone for more than 10 minutes. And what we realized later and what we were told from our sources was that that call was made by the Congress's president, Sonia Gandhi, telling him that attempt should be made to ensure that Sachin Pilot, some kind of a truce happens, that his feelings are assuaged, and that an attempt is made to bring him back to the main fold so that he has a platform to speak about what has his grievances been. That is when it was decided that Randeep Singh Surjewala will come out from inside, speak with media, and that is what happened at 4 o'clock. So clearly this climb down has come right from the top. The kind of equation that Sachin Pilot and his family has had with the Gandhi family somehow came in the scenario.
That's
and
right.
Once again, leaders who have so far been, you know, not that excited towards once again reaching out to Sachin Pilot, Randeep Singh Surjewala had to come out and make an fervent appeal once again to Sachin Pilot.
Hold on right there. Hold on to your thoughts right there. I'm requesting Maushami, Ashutosh, and Dev all to stay back with us. Now,
Hello everyone. This is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.